Hey, it's a Goron! Goron!
Yeah.
Nadon says, this is the East Ocula stable. If you have any ore, do not eat it. Instead, sell it at this stable. I already did that. Though I guess a non-Goron wouldn't be tempted to eat it anyway. Weird. Okay. When you arrive at a stable, you can sell them the things you don't need. I would just eat the rocks I don't need, but for a Hylian like you, I suppose you'd rather sell them? Yes. And unfortunately, his name does not end in Sun, so we can't send him over. Oh, is this, hey, it's the guy from, Kakariko. Oh, you're the guy who found the Great Fairy Fountain. Funny running into you here. Are you traveling too? I've traveled all over the world, so I'm happy to tell you about new places if you want. If you have a picture to show me, let's see it already. Oh, now we can show him a new picture. Okay, I know I've seen that spring and that goddess statue before. There was a place like this at the ruins in North Ocala Valley, to the west of here. Oh. North Ocala Valley to the west. So that's the spring of power that they talked about previously too, I think. It's pretty much directly west of here. I'm certain you'll be able to find it without any trouble. Thanks, Pekongo. So I guess we have to actually just go find him in random places out in the world. And that's when he'll tell us about new pictures. We can't just ask him any old time. And they don't let me pick either. It's like, you know, it's predetermined at each location. That's cool, though. Take? What am I taking? Oh, there's a wooden bow there. I don't need to take that. Donkey. Oh, there's a woodcutter's axe. Oh, I gotta take that. I've been missing a woodcutter's axe. We'll get rid of this traveler's spear. There we go. Okay. Hey, they have sconces here too. I wonder if I should light that just for the fun of it. Can I use this? I probably can't use this as a torch, can I? Oh, I can! Nice! Seriously? It's garbage! Okay, never mind. Alright, we talked to her, we talked to him. Who are you?
Hi!
Aya says, hello! Is something wrong? The blue flame. Oh, they do want a blue flame in this one. Hmm? Oh, sorry. Guess I was daydreaming. Life has been so dull since I married into this family. I used to pass the time by staring at the lantern's blue flame. But the director at the Ocala Ancient Tech Lab hasn't lit the fire in so long. The lab? Yes, its director used to light the lanterns with a blue flame for his experiments. But he's getting up there in age now, so maybe he can't get out as often as he used to. I'm talking about the Ocala Ancient Tech Lab right up this road if you haven't been. They remodeled it from an old lighthouse, so it's easy to spot. Yeah, I think that is the building that I marked out earlier, so. Okay, let's head inside. Actually, let's talk to this guy right quick. Rudy says, Welcome to our fine stable. Do you want to register a horse, take one out for a ride? How can I help? Wait, can we take a horse from here? Which horse do you want to take out? Asteroid is already taken out, but I guess we could take Moo Horse. You wanted Asteroid, right? Alright, we'll get Asteroid ready for you. Sit tight. Oh, so even if he's already taken out, we can, like, re-take him out from here. And there you go. Thanks for choosing us for all your horsey needs. To talk to someone while on horseback, just target them first. But you won't be able to talk to anyone if you're riding too fast, so slow it down. Nice. So that's how we get our horses back in, you know, the region that we're in, so we can call them, I guess. That's good to know. Hey, we got a recipe right here. That is, I think that's the same recipe I learned before, actually. Oh, we got a journal right there. One second.
Sabak.
It's a Gerudo lady! Laroba Savak.
Hmm?
Hey, kid. Yeah, I know you're a Vo, but you're still a kid to me. I don't know what a Vo is. I size up every Vo coming and going down the road for eligibility. They're different ages, sizes, sometimes even races, so it's hard to make a call. I probably look like a creep to them. Tell me more. You're not gonna tell me anymore. Okay. So the thing about Gerudos is, we haven't really had a chance to talk about that race. That's one of the races I don't know a ton about, but they do have a pretty interesting backstory. because they're actually directly tied into Ganon's origins, which is kind of part of a bigger discussion about the timeline, which I wasn't really planning on talking about right now, but soon. Very soon. Does he say anything different on this side? Oh, he just offers us a bed. No thanks. Okay, let's read this journal. Rumor Mill, Volume 4. This is Tracy. I have a taste for the rumors of worlds long gone and worlds yet to come. Everyone gossiping in the present world? Here's my favorite bit of the latest news. Treasures of the Falling Star. The star spread out in the sky like a tapestry, and across that expanse, you see one streak of light, a shooting star. And I've heard that there is treasure waiting where these stars have landed. The next time you see one, why not track it down to see where it lands? Tracy's recommendation? 4 stars. Okay, that sounds like it could be some really good loot waiting for us. I haven't seen a shooting star, but I very much would like to. What's glinting over here? Oh, what's this? Oh, the spear I threw. Thought I saw another glint up in this area. Maybe not. Okay. So, I just want to check this out. Where are we right now? We are... okay. North Akala Valley. This right here is probably the spring. That looks springish right there. They said it was directly to the west. I kind of wonder if it's worth going over there right now. I mean... because frankly, guys... once I get up here and do everything in the Akala Tech Lab, I'm probably going to want to jump over to this thing over here and see what this is all about. It's intriguing. It doesn't have a name on the map. So, I'm very curious. I think I'm actually going to change course here. Everybody stop the presses. The plan is changing. I'm going to come over here and see if this is the spring that has the memory. And maybe we'll even be able to learn something about the shrine quest while we're there too. Maybe find out what kind of relic we need. That might be a long shot. But I would be remiss if I didn't come check it out while I'm this close to it. And also, we can fast travel back up to the shrine when we're done, so... hopefully this won't be too long of a diversion. I always say that word funny, and I think it's because of Jane from the TV show Firefly. It's supposed to be just diversion, you know? Soft eye. But I always say diversion, because that's how Jane says it in Firefly. And I love that show, and I love Jane, so... it kind of rubbed off on me, I guess. Oh, look at that. We got some wild horses down here. Some mounted bokoblins. I don't really feel like dealing with them too much. Oh my god. Oh my god! Oh my god! We can drop bombs while we're gliding. Guys, I dropped a bomb on him while I was gliding. I didn't... oh my god. Okay. I wasn't even really trying to do that, it just kind of happened organically and it worked. And I'm really happy that I just figured that out. Stupid horse. Oh, this dude's one of those really strong ones. Oh shit, okay. Oh, that actually didn't hurt all that much. I was expecting to get wrecked from one hit. Eh. He does have some health. Come on! How'd that not hit? Oh. What the fuck? He's running right through my bombs! This is bullshit! Okay, this guy... he has some, like, super armor shit going on. Just shrugging off attacks, running right through bombs. Some bow shit. Yeah, that's awesome, though. Okay, this spear is a fan favorite among moblins. The spearhead is made from fossilized bones adorned with spikes, which greatly increase its stabbing power. Oh, but I can't care. How much does this thing do? 27? Oh, we'll get rid of the soldier spear. There we go. Yeah, I can't wait to just fly above all my enemies and rain death down on them. With this technique that I now know about. There's a drone. There's a drone over there. Wonder if he's protecting the spring. We did get a picture of them, didn't we? Yeah, Guardian Sky Watcher or whatever. We'll just steer around them. fucking fox. Okay, right down here, Spring of Power, yep. It was very close after all. Check this shit out, guys. This is a sacred place, full of ancient power and wisdom. Relatively untouched from the mess outside. Very pure. Let's go in and defile it right after we check this rock for a Korok. Hey! Alright. There you go, an extra rock will help decorate the place down there. Oh wow, that really didn't appear until I was like right on top of it. That little memory circle. So we can't really count on that until we're like very, very close to them. I'm not leaving, guys. I just wanted to see what the actual real entrance to this looks like. Looks like it's protected. We can walk right through the leaves. And then there's just like wolves and guardians and shit out here. Alright. Well, you guys just stay out there and do your thing. I'm gonna recover another memory. Oh! Hold on. I see a glint up here. There's something for us. Bird eggs! Sacred bird eggs. Yeah, look how close we have to be to this memory circle to actually get it to pop up. Yeah. That is really helpful that that dude let us know that this place was so close, because I would have missed it completely.
I come seeking help regarding this power that has been handed down over time. Prayer will awaken my power to seal Ganon away. Or so I've been told all my life. And yet, Grandmother heard them. The voices from the spirit realm. And Mother said her own power would develop within me. But I don't hear or feel anything. Father has told me time and time again. He always says, quit wasting your time playing at being a scholar. Curse you. I've spent every day of my life dedicated to praying. I've pleaded to the spirits tied to the ancient gods. And still the holy powers have proven deaf to my devotion. Please, just tell me. What is it? What's wrong with me?
Man, that Zelda has some real problems, doesn't she? I like the little lesson hidden in there about how prayer doesn't really do all that much. You should probably focus on some action. Get out there and do something. The gods don't give a shit, alright? Just putting that out there. Let's see if the statue has anything to say. As I directly contradict what I just said and pray to it. Oh? You have done well to find this spring. Offer Dinral Scale, received from the Red Spirit to the Spring of Power. I, Goddess Hylia, will guide you. Oh. Okay, well at least now we know what we're looking for. We still don't know exactly what it is. What's all this about? This looks like a secret door back here. Also, can I swim up the waterfall here? Nope. Alright, well that's fun. I'm gonna guess that Dinral is like the name of like a dragon or a spirit or something. Like one of those dragons we saw flying around. There's probably more than one. Which reminds me. I was reminded in the comments that Farash is something I've encountered before. It was probably the name of that dragon that we snapped a picture of. And he's going to have one of the items we need to upgrade one of our pieces of clothing. I forget which one already. But I was confused when I saw the item name. And I think that's the whole deal right there. Of course, there's so many of these damn things that it's... Well, we should start by not looking under equipment. How about that? There he is. Yep, Farash. A spirit of lightning has taken the form of this giant dragon, made its home in the Faron region. Said to have served the spring of courage since ancient times. An old saying goes, the dragon ascends to the heavens as the sun begins to set, but nobody has seen this in the current age. The electricity that coats its body makes it dangerous to get near, but Farash bears no ill will toward people. So we still don't know exactly what the deal is with those things, but it does say that he serves the spring of courage. So it sounds like each dragon or monster or whatever the hell you want to call it is going to be specific to a spring, and we have to collect some kind of item from them in order to get whatever this spring is going to give us. So that's my inference from all that. Alright, I dare say that was a worthy endeavor, but let's finally get up to this tech lab, guys. No more distractions. It's time. I'm trying to do this for like 2 hours. I gotta say, I really agree with what that lady said back there at the stable when she talked about how she likes the Akala region the best so far. I still haven't seen nearly everything in this game, but I really, really am enjoying this region. I think it's mostly about, like, the coloring, like the leaves on the trees and the foliage. This is a real fall area. It's got, like, an autumn feel to it, and autumn is by far my favorite season, so I feel right at home in here. I think it's beautiful, and I'm just really enjoying running around and exploring everything. Although, I will say, we haven't run across any super strong monsters like we were told we would. Maybe we'd have to go further up the road, or maybe there's a guardian right there! Oh shit! Me and my big mouth. Me and my giant fucking mouth. Okay, let's go ahead and blow these guys up, I guess. Don't shoot me, bro! Oh, caught myself in it. Ooh, almost got me. Okay, I'm not sure, but I think that dude just tried to pick up the other guy's head. That'd be a funny twist. Alright, so... we do have Amnesiac's Grace queued up. I am going to go ahead and, try and reflect this dude's sentinel beam. We need a one-handed or equipped. Here we go. Because if I fuck up, I should get revived. Ugh. Yep, okay. Well, I broke my shield. Fuck. I'm gonna lose all my shields trying this. Damn it! This is extremely difficult, guys. The timing on this is ridiculous. Yep.
It is my pleasure.
Thanks, Mipha. Okay, I'm done with that for now. I mean, if we could get the timing down on that, we would never have to fear another Sentinel. Or another Guardian. But, fuck, man. We're gonna lose all our good shields just attempting it. We could try the ancient arrow on him. That's supposed to really fuck up his Christmas. Do we want to spend it this early, though? You know what? I think we should. I think we should use our Lionel bow. And I think we should give this guy an ancient arrow to the face. Yep, that did it. Alrighty, well, now we know that those arrows aren't fucking around. They can one-shot a guardian. Whew, that's pretty great. I just hope that wasn't a waste. I mean, you would think it's not a waste. Using a great item like that on a freaking guardian, like... They're the toughest enemies in the game, arguably. At least up till now. I think they probably are a little harder than the Lynel was. I don't know, if I used a potion, that probably would've went better for me. Oh, that updraft. Holy shit! That is awesome. I want the loot, though. Oh, here it is. But yeah, I don't know. I guess the Guardians don't have as much health as the Lynels. So, that's not a fair comparison, because, yeah, I was using a potion in the Lynel fight. So the Lynels are probably still harder overall. A lot of fireflies around this area. Akala Ancient Tech Lab. We finally made it. This guy's gonna want us to get some blue flame too, I bet. Although, we don't know where to get it from here. Come on. I know you have loot. Quit bullshitting me. Seriously? Fine, keep your damn loot. See if I care. Asshole. Okay, so... That's definitely a maze over here. What is that place all about? It looks kind of terrifying. That's a shrine there in the middle. But what's the maze for? I don't know. It's kind of scary. We have no idea what's waiting for us in there. It looks somewhat intimidating. This dude's been, like, studying Guardians. Look, he's got them, like, hitched up there. Okay, these ones have loot. You know what'd be funny is if he gave us a quest to kill the active Guardian that was out there. We were just like, we already did that shit, bro. Okay, let's get inside. Oh, don't do it. Don't do it. Oh my god, it's happening. Oh, fuck. Ooh, that was close. Hey, you look like a little guardian person.
Hi.
Whoa. Hey, you! What are you doing here? Robbie is a very small person as well. What's going on? What is... Okay, that thing is having some issues. What up, Robbie? Are you the one called Link? Yep. That's too bad. If you were the legendary Link, there'd be something important I'd need to tell you. I mean, I said yes. But how can I determine with full certainty whether or not you are the true hero? Yes, how indeed? Yes, if you can show me the wounds your body suffered 100 years ago, that should prove you are truly Link. Is he asking me to get naked? I think that's what he's doing. Jaren says, who are you? Unless you're an acquaintance of Robbie's, I can't talk to you. Trade secrets, you know. Alright, you're gonna be a bitch. Can't read that book. There's a torch. Robbie's memoirs, to first page. Let me start from the beginning. It was 100 years ago. Calamity Ganon had already swallowed Princess Zelda. Dr. Pura and I had already taken Link to the Shrine of Resurrection and left him to recover. Dr. Pura and I departed for Kakariko Village, where we left Lady Impa. All three of us couldn't stay together, of course. We couldn't risk Calamity Ganon getting all of us in one strike. If that happened, there'd be no one left to deliver Princess Zelda's message to Link when he recovered and woke up. We had to ensure at least one of us would be able to talk to him. So Dr. Pura and I set out to survive as long as we could. We were lucky. We found large amounts of ancient energy in the Nakluta and Akala regions. We could continue our research. Just as we had in Hyrule Castle, we could again set ourselves to finding some way to seal Calamity Ganon away. We decided who would go where in the only fair way. Rock, paper, scissors. I set out for Akala soon after. That's Very true. It's the only fair way. I was all set to go to Akala, but first I decided to go with Dr. Pura to the ancient energy source in the Cluda. Actually, that implies I had any choice. Dr. Pura laid on a pretty heavy guilt trip when I suggested her going alone. In a world as dangerous as ours, are you seriously asking me to travel alone? She's so darn pushy. Anyway, Dr. Pura promised Lady Impa that they'd meet again someday, then she and I set out from Kakariko Village. But not before loading a cart with the guidance stone Dr. Pura had been using at Hyrule Castle. We traveled for some time, south of the Pillars of Levia, across Lake Ciela, and through Blatchery Plain. Then we came upon Fort Hateno. Link had battled an army of guardians there, and it was where he'd been defeated. A master swordsman such as Link, who'd impressed King Roam enough to be made Princess Zelda's personal knight. Well, even someone like that has their limits. I'm sorry, Link. I spent so much of my life researching the Guardians. Even with all my knowledge, I wasn't able to give you the weapons or power you needed to succeed. Those were my thoughts as I looked upon the broken husks of the Guardians strewn around Fort Hateno. Lost in my thoughts, I didn't notice that Dr. Pura had slipped away. I knew Hateno Village wasn't much farther along the road, and that the Calamity had barely touched that area. So I felt safe letting her continue on her own. We parted ways without even saying goodbye, I suppose. Stirring myself back to action, I set out on my own journey back toward Kakariko Village. With Dr. Pura escorted safely to Hateno Village, it was time for me to head to my new home in Akala. I returned to Kakariko Village to collect the remaining Guidance Stone, then I immediately set out for Akala. I made my way through the Lanayru Wetlands and headed towards Ternio Trail. I knew that once I crossed the Akala Span, I would officially be in Akala. The autumn leaves brought some joy to my spirit as I crossed Shadow Pass, then headed north from Ordurak Quarry. Akala is known for its long stretches of nothing. I set out hoping that would still be the case. I was attacked by a guardian here and there as I went, but remember, I'd spent my life studying them. Dispatching them individually was no challenge at all. In time, I reached the lighthouse in Akala. What a perfect place to keep an eye on the monsters out there. I unloaded my guidance stone and settled into my new home. And so began my life of solitary research. I knew I had to continue to research the ancient soldier gear for Link. He could wake at any time. I want some ancient soldier gear, guys. I quickly settled on a routine. First, I would carry the blue flame from Tumley Heights. Next, I would melt the ancient materials, refine the result, and then shape it into ancient soldier gear. It's difficult to say how much progress I made on my research. The routine demanded so much focus, day after day. But then I had a clever thought. I realized I could automate the entire refinement process. It took some significant work, but I was able to successfully remodel the guidance stone. Thanks to my effort, it can refine any ancient material inserted into it and offer something in return. Oh. I named this machine Cherry after the first girl I ever loved. It's cute. My research didn't end with the creation of Cherry, not at all. I realized that if she was able to refine the ancient materials, there was no reason she couldn't also manufacture ancient soldier gear too. Anyone can make ancient equipment. I also decided then that I wanted to be able to give her a voice so she could speak. Okay. I was filled with ambition then, but it was no easy task to make my dreams a reality. Automating the manufacturing process was extremely difficult. It took me decades to figure it out. I'll spare you the details of all the things that went wrong. But I will say it was complex enough that I had to put my desires to remodel Cherry on the back burner for a while. Days and months came and went. Before I even realized it, I'd reached the ripe age of 90. I would have been lost in my work even then, but around that time, a young woman named Jaren arrived. She first trained with Dr. Pura, then Lady Impa had sent her to aid me. She quickly proved herself quite capable. She carried the blue flame from Tumley Heights and even reworked and improved my designs for Cherry. The very fact that she had trekked all the way from Kakariko Village alone proved she was no ordinary girl. Her intellect, her spirit. In hindsight, is it any surprise that we eventually ended up married? Kinda, because you'd already built yourself a weird sex robot with Cherry, and she's still there, so. Thanks to Jaren's redesign, Cherry was soon crafting ancient soldier gear perfectly and speaking beautifully. She spoke better than any machine I'd ever heard. It would have been hard to tell she wasn't a native Hylian. If I said good morning, she'd respond with a sweet, "Good morning, Robbie." And she was helpful. Cherry, where'd I leave my book? It's the third book from the right on the second shelf, Robbie. She also knew to ask if she needed something. Robbie, could you increase the furnace heat a little? I'd always go personally to fetch more blue flame from Tumley Heights. I didn't realize our interactions hurt someone. That someone was Jaren. Perhaps it was due to her namesake, but my exchanges with Cherry hurt Jaren. Yeah, kinda saw that coming. Despite the fact that she knew Cherry was only a machine, she still felt uneasy with my interactions with her. She was in tears when she told me. She knew it made little sense, and yet she couldn't help how she felt. I was devastated. I hadn't even realized the pain I was causing. Although Jaren had designed Cherry, she was not being hurt by her own creation. We agreed to restore Cherry to her original mechanical way of speaking. I took it upon myself to make the changes. From then on, I was careful to not refer to her as Cherry. Doing so would anger my wife. Instead, I called her ancient oven. Sometime later, Jaren gave birth to a baby boy, a beautiful young one who bore all the features of his mother. We decided to name him Grante, and together we passed the time as a happy family at Ocala Ancient Tech Lab. It was, unfortunately, only a temporary peace. Princess Zelda did her best to contain Calamity Ganon. Around the time Grante turned 3, a letter from Dr. Pura arrived. It was a shock to receive it. The last time she'd written, it was to talk about an assistant from Kakariko Village whom she felt was useless. She was ready now to let me know she completed research on powering up the runes, like stasis. Hearing this reinvigorated my interest in researching ancient soldier gear. Grante grew fast, and it wasn't long before he towered over me. He loved to carry a blue flame from Tumley Heights, calling it a chance to train his body. I could see the curiosity in his eyes, and so I encouraged him to travel the world and see as much as he could. He'd always been independent, but I was still surprised when, the very day I told him to travel, he left. Writing about Grante's training reminds me. A few days before he left, I thought it might be a good idea to have Grante study with Dr. Pura. I wrote to her to ask what she thought of such an idea, and she sent a letter that simply said, "Don't send anyone here." I wonder what happened to her to make her say such a thing. Oh, that was the end. I was so focused on the writing, I wasn't looking at the prompts. Wow, that was a lot of info right there. Those journals in these tech labs are always really long.